Drone honeybees are probably the most underappreciated of all the honeybees in the honeybee colony. They are the male bees, and they result from unfertilized eggs, meaning drones have no fathers. Their sole purpose is to mate with the queen. That's why they exist. They cannot contribute any other task to the hive. They can't build wax, they can't forage for nectar, they can't even defend the nest. So let's start from the beginning to get us from egg to adult drone and follow their life cycle and understand more about them. So when a queen lays an egg that's unfertilized, it develops into a drone. Drones develop in large cells. In fact, the cells are larger than those of worker cells. They are oriented horizontally, like the cells from which workers are raised, but instead they are bigger, and oftentimes people call them bullet shaped because when that cell is capped, you get a very domed appearance on the capping. Drones take 24 days to develop from egg to adult, and one of the interesting things about drones is that their sperm actually develop while they are larvae. That's when they are producing the sperm. And as they move into the pupal stage, those sperm begin to mature, and as the pupae drone develops into an adult and the adult drone emerges, those sperm will then migrate to different parts of the drone's abdomen where they will finish maturing. When drones are roughly 2 to 3 weeks old, they become sexually mature and are capable of going on mating flights to mate with queens. An interesting thing about drones is while their purpose is to mate with queens, they actually die in the act of mating with a queen. Anatomically, drones are quite different from workers and queens. For example, they are large bees. They're not as long as the queen, but they are much bigger than the worker. If you look at a drone's head, the most notable feature about the drone are two large compound eyes. Drones have large eyes because they have to find the queen while they are flying so that they can mate with the queen. So these large eyes help them hone in on the queen during flight. If you look at the drone's abdomen, it's rounded at the tip rather than pointed at the tip like you see with workers and queens. Drones don't have stingers. They're incapable of stinging. You can pick up a drone and handle a drone at no risk to yourself. And the reason they don't have a stinger is that stings are modified ovipositor. Ovipositor simply means egg-laying organ, ovipositor. So since drones don't have the ability to lay eggs, they don't have stings that develop in them, unlike queens and workers. Because historically, biologically, drones have never had the ability to lay eggs, they haven't developed stings, so drones cannot sting. Now, I want to go back a little bit to the function of a drone in the honeybee colony. Remember, they exist principally to mate with queens, and as a result, workers will invest in the production of drones during times of the year where virgin queens are more available. So those times of the year typically include swarm season, which will be much of spring, and then a little bit into summer. So what you'll see is that queens will begin laying unfertilized eggs in early spring. Workers will carry those eggs all the way to adulthood, the adult drone, and you'll get this peak population of drones in your colony somewhere mid to late spring, maybe 2,000 to 5,000 drones in that nest. And those drones, once they're sexually mature, leave the colony every day to go to drone congregation areas to look for queens with which to mate. If they are unsuccessful, they return to the hive. The vast majority of adult drones will never accomplish their biological purpose. They will never mate, the vast majority of them. Thousands of drones may be made by a single colony, but never able to achieve their purpose. As summer progresses into fall, the inability of drones to contribute meaningfully to the overall function of the hive means that the worker bees will evict the drones from the nest. They literally kick the drones out of the entrance of the nest, and they won't let the drones return to the nest. They keep them outside the nest where the drones die from starvation or exposure. So it's the mass eviction of drones in fall as that colony is readying itself for winter. They can't afford to have drones in the nest taxing the colony's resources when the drones aren't otherwise useful to the nest. all of this talk about drones and the vast majority of them will never mate and they're kicked out of the hive in late summer, early fall really make it sound as if drones are valueless, as if they have no purpose in the nest at all. But honestly, nothing is further from the truth. Remember, queens can lay two types of eggs, fertilized and unfertilized eggs. Drones don't contribute really to the unfertilized egg, right? They're not fertilizing those eggs, but they contribute very importantly to the fertilized egg. Remember, a queen lays a fertilized egg. That egg is only genetically half her. The other half is the drone. That's why drones are so important. Having quality drones from quality colonies ready to mate with those virgin queens in spring or throughout the mating season is incredibly necessary to ensure that your queens are well mated, have enough genetic diversity represented in their spermatheca, so that the population of workers that are working in the nest are genetically diverse and can weather any storm that nature throws their way. Drones are as important to the production of females in the nest as queens are important to the production of females. Think back to a statement I made earlier, how drone sperm really comes into existence while those drones are developing as larvae. Then you can imagine how important rearing environment is to the overall quality of that drone as it flies to a drone congregation area and is available to mate with the queen. So an inability to make honey? Yes. An inability to build wax? Of course. An inability to defend the nest? Absolutely. But they are no less important to the health, productivity, and the perpetuation of the honeybee colony.